Hello everyone, it's Father Simon here again. I'm here to talk about, as you might have guessed from this, Advent. Now we know Advent is the special getting ready time for Christmas. It's full of hope and waiting and expectation. But when does Advent actually start? Well, I expect most of you will think Advent starts on the 1st of December, because that's when you first open your Advent calendars and eat your first chocolate from your Advent calendars, unless of course you've already eaten it, which you shouldn't have done, because it's not quite 1st of December yet, is it? Those who've got really good memories may remember that last year Advent did begin on the 1st of December. Sunday the 1st of December was the first day of Advent last year. But for the church, Advent begins on a slightly different date each year. It's always at the end of November or the beginning of December. And this year it starts on Sunday the 29th of November, this coming Sunday for me, and we're filming this on Friday. And that's because Advent always begins on a Sunday, because there are always four Sundays in Advent, the last four Sundays before Christmas. Hence the four red candles, which we light on each of the Sundays, starting with this coming Sunday, Sunday the 29th. And then, of course, we light the white candle either late on Christmas Eve or on Christmas Day itself. Now, I think Advent can be summed up in a couple of words: watch and wait. We know what we're waiting for. It's Christmas, isn't it? We know what that's about. But what are we watching for? What are we looking for? Well, we can look for signs of Christmas, and we can look, as Jesus says in the Bible to his followers, signs of God's coming kingdom. That kingdom of God that he talks about, which is that place of love and joy and peace that his heavenly Father promised to us through Jesus. And we see lots of things to do with Christmas as this time comes about, don't we? We see the Christmas lights in the high street. We see people putting their decorations out. We see all the Christmas things in the shops which we can buy. But there are other things I think we should look out for, less obvious things, which I think are even more important than all those things that make you so excited that Christmas is drawing near. I'd like to call them little acts of kindness. When you see someone being unusually helpful and kind at school, in the street, in a shop, at home, when you see someone being very generous to others who don't have much, where people are helping people through the food bank, or bringing gifts for Home Start for families who can't afford Christmas presents for their children, in some cases can't afford even to give their family a Christmas dinner. When you see someone putting someone else before themselves and helping them first before they help themselves, then you see acts of kindness that are signs of the kingdom of God. That the kingdom of God isn't just something in the future, it's here now, in those acts of kindness and love. That's where we find the love of God, the love of Jesus, and signs that a real Christmas, which is about a gift, the special gift, the most important gift of all, the gift of the baby Jesus, a gift coming to the whole world. Mary and Joseph went to Bethlehem and they couldn't find anywhere to stay. There was no room in the inn, but someone found them a place. We usually think it's the innkeeper, but we don't know. We certainly don't know their name. Found them somewhere to stay. Yet it was where the animals were, but it was warm and it was dry and it was safe. It was somewhere where Mary could have her baby safely. So the baby Jesus was born. So watch for those signs. Wait, and I know you hate waiting for Christmas. You want it to come tomorrow, but it's not going to. It's going to come on the 25th of December, as it does every year. There's another word too. Watch, wait, and pray. Because praying goes with watching and waiting. If you're looking for those signs of God's kingdom, in a way you are praying, find some space each day at school or at home where you can have a quiet moment to pray to God, to say thank you for the good things you have, and the things you're looking forward to at Christmas, but also to think about those who don't have so much, who need our love and God's care. Perhaps you too can show those little acts of kindness in your life each day, so you can help that kingdom come a bit closer and grow, as Jesus asks us to pray for it to come. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Then you can make this Advent really special this year. And now I'm going to light the Advent wreath and say a prayer. First candle on the Advent wreath lit. Advent's beginning. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, light of the world, born in David's city of Bethlehem, born like him to be a king, be born in our hearts this Christmas as we wait and watch and pray, and be king of our lives today and all days. Amen.
Amen.
Watch, wait and pray, everyone. Have a good Advent and a wonderful Christmas. See you soon.